What's going on, everyone? My name is RazorFan, and welcome to part number 19 of Race Pool. We're almost halfway there to complete Group E. So the next country we're gonna do is the only Netherlands call. Yeah, I couldn't think of a term for other than Netherlands. So this is the Spyker C8, also the only main factor in the Netherlands. And this is in the critical car. So yeah, we're gonna use this and transition. Alright, the trial is now done, and no contract for 2,500 credits. Three races would be... Oh yes, this is the other track! This is the last new track we're going to. We'll explain that later. It's our first race to be at Oscar 7. And yeah, let's go. Let's go! Oh, so now challenging against 8 other drivers now. They put me in 5th place, that's good. Yeah, so yeah, now I got new things to talk about. Yay for that! Also, it's really enough how they use the Spyker CA and they just made it to a race car version of it. How they made a race car version of it. Yeah, I really do like how they made race car versions of world cars, because they make those faster. Not just to impress the not just like, you know, in more sport history, just to put stickers on there and make it to a race car machine. They're actually faster than world cars. You would know that for sure. Seriously, it's still weird how they, you know, made Spyker CA into a race car. We've seen a C8 and Test Drive Unlimited. Well, there's a lot of left and there's a Spyro. So you know, when you see the Spyro T, when you see the T and the model's name of the CA Spyro, it must mean that they're equipped with a turbocharged engine. Or turbocharged boosted engine, yeah. It's really weird how they made a CA as a race car. Anyways, yeah. So I'll tell you a little bit about the recording. I actually do record in the morning. I mean, that's not the first thing I do when I wake up. Usually I just watch videos, cause yeah. Interesting videos that I watch. And yeah, I watch videos first thing in the morning, and around like 11 AM from where I am I usually just bring my computer out into the living room, connect the cables from the capture card to the computer to the TV, and then just record from there on. In this game, I would just record like 2 to 3 parts of this, because that's my body feels. But now, I'm actually recording in the afternoon though. I usually don't go in the afternoon because my brother coming home like daily. And I'm surprised that he didn't come home today though, by the time this is recorded. Yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna record like 3 to 4 parts on this day, so I can like get more content out. I also have more than enough content in order to be released out into the future once I go on vacation, cause yeah. I'll be gone for like 15-16 days, also no streams during that time. I'll be gone for like August 2nd to like the 17th. Yeah, I'll be gone from those days for around 2 weeks, and I really need to get more content out there. this let's play might end around the beginning of August. Critical acclaim to this let's play as it's received a like and a dislike though. I mean, yeah, that's what people are going into. Some people like the game, some people don't, so yeah, that's what it's gonna be like. Anyways, yeah, there was another thing I wanted to talk about. I actually opened up a casting call account for the casting call club if you want to be in like a project. Most likely on the tier list, since I did see these casting call pages, so there was one for an animated series that might be going up to, according to plan though. In a couple parts ago, I talked about As First and Company. So I actually had destined to be an Asker voice on As for the Company for episode 2, and I saw one of the sentences I voiced that, but I watched the episode and I did not make it in. But hey, if you saw the end of episode 5 of season 1 of As for the Company web show, I'm pretty much having spoilers already. But yeah, Frisk announced that if people want to become a voice and ask a voice and ask for the company, they should visit the casting call page. So, they set up like a set of asks by the askers, and they apparently have a chance to audition to be a voice. That page will also be updated every week, to add more lines. I'm trying to talk clearly to tell you guys so. And if you don't make it this week, you can always try again. So yeah, you have a chance next week to do so, and that's what I'll do. And also, like, since As for the Company Season 2 corresponds with another show called Man Who Speaks in Hands, there was another cast call page where they have auditions for, you know, fans to be voices for askers on Man Who Speaks in Hands, because, yes, there are askers on there. And, I also auditioned to be one of the askers in Man Who Speaks in Hands for Episode 2, though. So, and I felt really cute though, but also very impressed to say the least, because when I saw the additions, it was at least a distance of what Season 2 of As for the Company has developed with us. So there were like, you know, 10 less additions or 20 less additions left in there. So yeah, I saw a ask that I wanted to voice and I've done it. Yeah, the way this is how it works is that you have to open up an account and then also put down your name so, you know, people can know what your name is. Just nickname, not your actual name, though. You gotta record a file. The audio software I use is Audacity, so yeah, it can record your commentary, other people's commentary. Record your voice on saying those words in the askers onto Audacity, and then export the audio, and then, you know, when you submit the auditions, you have to select the MP3 file, select that file that you just recorded, and then, like, submit the audition, and then bam, you're done. You can even hear other people's auditions to see what they have done. Yeah, I feel like I talked about this video, and what is the AI doing? Wow. Can't believe the AI just done that. Yeah, my god. I can't believe I got that, you know, talk out of the way. Alright, race number 2 is at Macau. Let's go. Hey, they put me up on the podium. Hey, I'm signed 3rd right now. Behind the Corvette and the Marshall. But they turn right, as usual. And this goes. No, I put my way to 2nd and I'm right behind this Corvette. So yeah, that talk got out of the way. About As for the Company and Man Who Speaks in Hand, so. Cause yeah, I'm maybe okay, Corvette. You seriously got. Yep, he brake checks me. And that's what the opponents do. They brake check a lot. By my words, I mean brake a lot. Like slow down. They don't even care about passing me. Okay, we find someone who cares now. Find someone who cares now, but it's because I brake too hard going to that turn. Anyways, yeah, so yeah, I auditioned and I didn't make it in. I just wasn't closely for my ask that I auditioned for, and apparently I didn't make it in. I mean, it's nothing to be ashamed of, though. I would imagine a little kid being ashamed that they didn't make it in. I think that was me, like, one time. I don't want to share it, because I don't remember. Yeah, but I can imagine little kids being ashamed and crying because they didn't make it in to an important event and stuff. But, you know. So, yeah. So, one down again. This is the second time telling, but just to make it simple. Open up a Casting Call Club account. Put down a nickname, like specifically your channel name or something like that. Record on Audacity, the example of one of those audio softwares. Record your voice, saying one of those asker lines and stuff. And export the audio into your computer. When you submit the audition, select the audio file, and make sure that is your asker voice that you just done. Select that, and then submit it, and there you go. It also gives you the selection that you can listen to other people's auditions as well. I listened to others and they all wanted to get in. Yeah. So yeah, that's pretty much done. And knowing that I auditioned for Man of Speaks and Hands and that I want to try again for as voice and comedy, I really wanted to just be voice and make a voice in one episode though of each show, because hey, you can't I just feel like that once you audition for it, you can't audition for another though. I feel like that because yeah, when I watched the top 50 things that you didn't know about as voice and comedy, there was like over Undyne, just like the state of the fact that there were over 1200 auditions for Ask a Voice on Casting Call Club, and Metaton, this is the fact that there were over 200 names thinking each and single one of those people that has made it to be an Ask a Voice on Season 1 of Ask Voice the Company. Yet again. Wait, I haven't said this before, but yet, there were a lot of people that were interested in the show and wanted to be featured on the show, yeah. Even though it's like, you know, a cameo appearance by voice, still, I appreciate what the show is doing for us, and I greatly appreciate them. I am subscribed to them as well, and you guys should probably subscribe to them too, because, they're all good people, and they all, and that is a good show. Other than the fact that there's another YouTuber called Ultima Almighty. Yep, fine, saying his name out there. He makes primarily reaction videos. It was supposed to be like a gaming channel, even though that happens most likely every other day though. But still, his reactions, as the Ask Voice Company team, as also listed to the fact by Carla. Yeah, their name. I used to call them like Chawa and stuff, but by the time I've heard a lot of people say the name like Kayla, and then when I heard Ask Voice Company say Carla, and some other people, I've started to get into Kayla more, but with that team, I feel like I should say Carla more, because yeah. Carla as in vroom vroom vroom, that's how they pronounce it. Like a car, you know, like the one I'm driving. Carla. Yeah, that's weird just to say that name, but I'm just gonna call them Carla from now on. Yeah, so yeah, Carla. Let's also listen to the fact that the cast usually watches Ultima Mighty's reaction videos together. And oh boy, they do love that those reactions. So do I though. He's interesting to watch. And I'm not trying to say that you should make fun of him. He doesn't like deserve to make fun of. To make fun of though. He really is an interesting person to watch though. Also the latest video where he stated that he's a nerd, that he's starting to come to nerd heaven. There were a bunch of stuff that he got that he really liked. That was in anime shows and stuff. Sorry about the long pause. So it's not because of the video I'm watching. It's because I heard a door kind of close, and I thought that someone was coming home. It must have been who was next to her, but I did hear a door close. All I want is just to get this game done, and pretty sure that's what other people want too. Possibly. And yeah, so yeah. Ultimate's a pretty good guy, you should check him out. He's got over 75,000 subscribers as of now. And also at both the times when this is recorded and by the time this video comes out, he has over 75,000 subscribers. And also, the audition I did for Man of Speaks and Hands. Try to find my voice in those auditions. If you are gonna listen to other people's auditions for Ask Voice the Company or Man of Speaks and Hands, try to find my voice though. See if you recognize one of those voices as me, cause yeah. I am able to practice my voice acting skills to the public and those shows and stuff. Yeah, with the least number of editions I made with Sticks and Hands as, I can pretty much guarantee that my voice would be in there, because I looked at the other ones for that, you know, ask set, and I feel like that my voice has come up more general to them, that they're more so I could pick that out. If it don't pick it out, well, I guess I have to try again for next week. Oh yeah, oh man, I'm gonna have to get my charger again, because I forgot to bring out my charger when I was ready to record this part. I don't want to repeat everything all over again. I worked my way up to this. And this race is long, and the next race might be even less very long too. I might just have to get my charger once the loading screen is here. No wait, that's a new track, I can't do so. So I might have to act faster. Gotta say, this track is long. This track is definitely long. Oh god, six. I wasn't looking where I was going for a moment there. That's why my left front crashed into the wall. It's not majorly damaged as I looked at it. I just like how the Spyker C has like a top that is topless. You see right there. Some cars do this, like the MX-5 Cup. and now the C8. That's pretty weird. It was gonna rain. I don't know what would become of the car now. The car C, that is. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you. Or I think I told you before. This game does have rain physics. So if there's any race in the contracts that involves rain, you're in for a surprise though. I mean, I hope that I get encounter a race with rain. I hope that happens. Oh god, I'm in a wall. Oh, I go into the hairpin turn. Going into here. And yeah, I think this is our first race that we just got past 10 minutes. As you see on the top left corner of the screen. This is definitely our first race that got over 10 minutes long. Yeah, doesn't matter by second, doesn't matter by minute. This is a race that I got past 10 minutes, that got over 10 minutes. Alright, so this race is now done. I feel like I'm talking more in this part than in the last part and stuff. Whoa, that AI just saved that car like crazy. Let's see how much time I have left. I'm pretty sure I have enough time though. It says I have 20 minutes left on battery. Yeah, pretty sure. Alright, last race is taking place on a new track, one of my favorites. Autodromo Nazionale Monza. That's pretty much how you pronounce it. The Monza. Okay, they put the word D in there. Okay, we cannot control. Yeah, I must have been squeezing on the cord too much with my legs and stuff. Yeah, so this is the interesting track that Formula 1 races at. And the tough part is that you have to master those two chicanes as you see right there though. You know, those corners in red color. Alright, so I'm starting 6 and yeah. I didn't exactly imagine Monza though. We passed an M3 GTR there. That was slowing down. And it's holding off that rear pack though. Yep. Okay. Oh, I did not get a warning though. Okay, so yeah, that's a tough corner that you gotta master though. That you gotta get through. I think the trick is that you're gonna have to brake extra early to get through that turn, because that is a chicane. And if you even think about going straight in that turn, well, you're screwed. You'll get a warning for cutting the track and possibly a drive-through penalty. I think it's for possibly for like, you know, passing cars. Passing cars for off the track, yeah. Passing cars for cutting the track. I think, you know, that driver penalty will occur if you pass a car while cutting the track. So yeah, this is a tricky course though, and yeah, this game has strict rules about, you know, cutting the track and stuff. I wonder what lap time we'll get on this track though, cause, yeah. I can tell for a fact that this is not, you know, the longest track ever. And you see that bridge above? That's part of the supposed Monza Oval. Yeah. I think I talked about that that this track did once had a oval track, and it's still there. But people don't really race on it, so. I see that bridge. That, you know, part of the road is actually part of the oval track. It goes over the road course. And you know, that straightaway at the start finish line is actually part of the oval as well. Just gotta find, like, you know, the exit though. Look at that, that's the exit right there. And I even tried going on there, but the game won't let me. Seriously. And I don't even know where the entrance is. Yeah, something right there. I think I saw like a wall though that was able to let us, you know, just go onto that road. I think that was the entrance though. And yeah, I don't really understand. I mean, like Forza 6 or 5 started allowing Monza to be in this game, and the only configurations that it has for Monza have to be the Force Circuit, the Force Circuit alternative, which is just no chicane there for the first one. Because the second one, you can't actually, there isn't actually a road that you, that you can go through that. Yeah. So that's the first circuit alternative, no chicane in the first one. And the short circuit, well, it's not actually the oval. It actually takes a type of road that goes on the last straightaway though of this track. Yeah, so yeah, this is an interesting track, and yeah, I can't wait for people to like race on it more, even though I don't follow the smaller sports that are racing on this track. But still, I really like this track. I first actually knew of this, I think in Gran Turismo 5, when the track was being added to the series. Yeah. Yeah, I think I first knew of it when this track was added to Gran Turismo 5. Still, such an amazing track. So, lap times are going to be around 2 minutes long. That's, by the time I'm predicting here, I'm pretty sure I'll have enough time before the laptop battery gives out. Oh my god, that world is going to bother me. Yep, look at this. That's my sub 2 minutes. But I still got 2 more laps to go though. Now that all the tracks have been introduced in this game, I'd like to know, what is your favorite track out of all of these? I would say mine is World America. I'm not saying it's my all time favorite track, so I would say it's my favorite out of this game though. Monza is still cool, and the stroke was pretty cool too, that it, but that airfield in Valencia is pretty cool. I don't know about Cordoba though, even though it's a Brazilian track, and my friend is from Brazil but never been there. I'm not sure about that being, of me liking that track. The info is kind of weird. I know it's just me criticizing things. I like the Laguna Seca. I like the idea how the corkscrew just messes people up. Okay, I'm on low battery, I'm on power save mode, I'm gonna have to be gone for a little bit because I gotta get my charger real quick. Okay, I am back. And I did cut that out though, when you guys have seen the video though. I'm not even sure because, yeah, this is about commentary and stuff. What's really in a voice? I mean, like, the laptop and power save mode could mean several different things. I sincerely had a bad feeling that my laptop was gonna give out before this race was gonna be done, and I didn't want that happening again. So when I saw the incident, I quickly decided to just, you know, pause the game, stop the record, Well, not exactly something coining, but take my headset off, because the headset is plugged into the computer, and the live commentary setting is using the mic, you know, that I'm wearing. Oh my god, I'm sweating right now. And I just decided to run to where my laptop charger was. Yeah, unplug it from the power outlet it was at, and then plug it into the nearest power outlet and charge my computer. And yeah, that's what I have to do. I mean, like, it worked for a little while. I knew that, like, you know, that the CSR260 part was had to be re-recorded. As I said in that part and stuff. Still at 42 subscribers on this channel though by the time this is recorded. We like the game like 8 more, cause I'll be able to do that special live stream that you guys wish for. Yeah. Under the bridge. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna go into the last turn right now. Gonna go into the last turn right now? Right here. The Spyker C8. I really like how I see a science puma on like the banner. Okay, what? How? Why is the AI feel stupid like that? Oh yeah. Oh my god. That was definitely a save there for the AI controlling the Spyker C8 when I finished the race. I started to think, what was the AI doing? But then I see the amazing save that he's done. 4,500 credits and contract earnings. Got the team points card and still an open top though. And the team silver. Ooh, I expected a standing contract by Snakeskin Green? What? Paying 500 credits. What are they talking about? Oh, we're gonna drive a first world car in career mode. Stick around for that. Hello everyone. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you all have a